Hello everybody, my name is Natalia Lee and I am the author of the young adult novels Highborn and Way of Spears. Are you constantly plagued by mischievous plot bunnies and shiny new ideas? Worry no more, because today I'm going to share my top 5 tips with you about how to deal with the plot bunnies and new ideas that are trying to tempt you away from your current work in progress. If you've never heard of a plot bunny before, these are pesky story ideas that refuse to go away until they've been written. They pop up at the most inopportune times, and they try to convince you to write them instead of the story that you are already working on. However, all of these new ideas can keep you from ever finishing a project, so take my advice and try to not let them run away with you. All right, my first tip is to not even think about it. Do not let yourself go there. Let these ideas drift on by like bunny-shaped clouds, because the more time that you spend thinking about these plot bunnies, the more you're going to want to write the story. So just do not let yourself go there. Do not. My second tip is to ignore those plot bunnies by listening to the playlist you've put together for your novel, looking back at your inspiration board, doing some character art, and rereading your outline. The more you dive back into your own manuscript and into the world you're creating, the less tempted you will be to start an entirely new story. You've already put so much time and energy into the characters and the story that you are working on, so don't let them down. Alright, tip number 3. If you cannot get this bunny to just shoo away, then give it a little bit of attention. Write down whatever it tells you, but do not write that story. Store everything away in an envelope and put it away until you finish your current work in progress. Tip number 4, if you are feeling ready to just abandon your manuscript for a new plot bunny idea, then just remember that these plot bunnies are going to show up again and again and again, and your frustration is just going to increase every time you chase one of them. This is a horrible trap to fall into, and you are never going to finish a novel if you let them run away with you. Plot bunnies and shiny new ideas tend to pop up while we are having difficulties with our current project. For me, this is usually while I'm writing Act 2 because it's the big middle chunk of the novel and sometimes it's really hard to trudge through. And I used to abandon my novels in order to pick up a new project that I thought would be easier. But the thing is, novels never get easier. We have to push through the things that are causing us frustration and problems in order to grow as writers. If we just continue to abandon our manuscripts, we're never going to learn anything new and we're never going to be able to finish anything, which is really what we're all striving to do. A very high percentage of people say that they want to write a novel, but a very small percentage of people are ever able to. So do not chase those plot bunnies and get yourself into the small percentage of people that have ever finished a novel. All right, my 5th and final tip. If that plot bunny just will not go away, then allow yourself to dive into the world a little bit. Write down everything you can, maybe do some character sketches and do a little bit of outlining, but after you have done all of that, store it away in that same envelope or binder or computer file and put it away. After you've done that, spend at least 1 more month working on your current project. These shiny new ideas are usually short-lived, and it takes a little bit of distance from them for us to realize how problematic they can be. They might be full of plot holes or a story idea that's already a cliche or something that we really don't want to write. So by writing everything down and then storing them away, we're allowing ourselves to get a little bit of objectivity and some distance from them so that we can see those ideas clearly and then decide later on if we actually want to go back and write them. Just remember that one of these days you're going to have to stick to a story and be loyal to it if you ever want to finish anything. I know that there are many writers out there that keep starting projects and abandoning them, and I used to be one of those writers until I learned that I had to see my novels through to completion. Remember, starting a new story will seem fun at first, but it will become difficult as well. And as soon as you hit that wall, you're going to want to chase another plot bunny. So just do yourself a favor and do not allow yourself to chase them. All right, those were my top 5 tips, and now I'm going to answer a few questions from my followers on Twitter. The first question is, how can I just sit down and write? I always take forever to write, and it is draining to say the least. I have 2 tips for this. One is when you leave off writing at the end of a day or at the end of a writing session, leave off at an exciting point in the story, because if you write all the way through the exciting point and then you get to another kind of dip in the action or you're not sure where to go next, then when you come back the next day and you pick it up, you're not gonna know what to write and you're going to be stuck. So remember to leave it off right there in the middle of the action so you're excited to return to it the next day. And then my second tip would be to know where you're going with the story. My hardest writing days are when I sit down and have no idea what I'm doing or what I want the characters to do, because then they just wander in circles and I just sit there and stare at the screen for hours. So if you go back to your outline and you know exactly where you're headed, then you'll be able to sit down and make the most of your limited writing time and really move your characters and the story forward. The next question is, how on earth do you organize your thoughts when you go through these bursts of ideas? Now, my latest burst of ideas was after the seminar that I went to, because I had a bunch of new ideas and then I started listening to my playlist and I got even more ideas. And honestly, at first, I do not even try to organize them. I have a file on my computer and in Scrivener that I will just write all of my ideas down in. And if I am not around my computer, then I will either write them in a notepad document on my cell phone or my iPod, or just sketch them in the little notebook that I carry with me. If I try to organize them too soon and too fast, I just get stressed out by it. So I like to just kind of word vomit everything up. And then later, when I am back to my outline, I'm able to look back at all those new ideas that I had, and I can kind of filter through them. I can decide which one will actually fit into my novel, and then I can drag it over into my outline and start filling it in there. Or I realize that it was kind of a fun idea, but it would just take way too much work to implement in the story, or it really doesn't suit the characters at all, and then that idea I just get rid of. Or if you feel like it's an idea that could maybe help you with a different story, then I would just save that in a separate story file so that you don't lose it. I probably end up using about 50% of my ideas. A lot of them get thrown out because they're just something that I think of like on a whim, something comes to me. And often it sounds like a lot of fun, but then I go back to my story, into my outline, and I realize that that could never work because I would have to change everything, or I'd have to get rid of a character or completely add a new character, and I just know that it is not worth it to try to fit that little idea in. So when you get these bursts of ideas, make sure to write them all down and then really take your time to go back through them and decide which ones will make your story stronger and which will just pull you down. Thank you both so much for your questions. I love answering those. I hope this video helped you out in some way. I know that plot bunnies and shiny new ideas used to distract me all the time, but thankfully I have moved past those days and I am now able to stick out the projects that I am working on. If you have any more questions about plot bunnies or new ideas or how I handle them, go ahead and comment down below and I will make sure to get back to you about that. You can also message me on Twitter, Tumblr, or Facebook. I love to just chat, so please do not hesitate to contact me. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe for a bunch of new videos about writing, reading, my writing process, writing seminars, and just so much more. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye!